Hi, everybody. I'm Eric Mansfield. Welcome to Clinton, Ohio, just south of Akron on the southern tip of Summit County, where a special memorial to Ohio's Vietnam veterans is taking shape. Certainly, we're all familiar with the wall in Washington, but the state of Ohio hasn't had a place to honor its Vietnam veterans until now. We'll take a look at how this project came together, why it's more than just a monument. We'll take a little bit of a tour, and we'll hear from the veterans themselves and why it's so important to remember. Join me for this special edition of NewsNite Akron as Ohio pays tribute, a long overdue one, to its Vietnam veterans. America's role in Vietnam was violent, costly, and defined a generation. More than 58,000 U.S. troops fought and died in the war, including more than 3,000 from Ohio, meaning that one out of every 19 troops killed in Vietnam hailed from the Buckeye State. Even though the war eventually came to a close, our country has struggled to come to grips with how to remember these fallen heroes, eventually deciding on a national memorial in Washington, the Wall. But for Ohio, it wasn't until 2006, when a small but motivated group found an opportunity in the tiny village of Clinton to turn a vacant field into something special.
It just takes somebody to have an idea and create a spark and then others to join in. So it just happened to be the right time.
In military-like fashion, the group began raising funds for the project while simultaneously putting their vision into action. First, a mock-up, models, and retooling, some adjustments, and then telling the story with animation. A 125-foot wall would be the centerpiece, with the names of all of Ohio's fallen heroes, 3,094 of them listed in alphabetical order. The wall would be surrounded by smaller monuments, paying tribute to operations and specific units. Benches, special flags, and more would round out the memorial. No longer an idea, the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Park was quickly becoming a quest.
Some veterans started this, I think, 5 or 6 years ago, the idea of it, and until it came to Summit County, it kind of blossomed.
A lot of really, really hard work. Most people didn't want to listen to us at that point because they didn't know that it was ever going to happen. It looked like a big project, and it is. It's a $1.7 million project, and they're like, where are you going to get the money? And we're like, from people like you.
It's been interesting. They've gone through several different phases, but it's great to see it come to fruition like it is now. And we've got more to do, but this is a great continuing step.
By 2008, the group broke ground and began bringing this tribute to life.
We have monuments. We go in between each of the trees. These are all at various donation levels. As you see here in the front, the benches is another donation level.
People just kind of stood back and watched for a couple of years. Once we got the land, that was pretty much a turning point for us. Then we could say, yes, we have a site. And then we began, as we got a little bit of money, we began to try to show progress. Like we put in the foundation, and then we put in the walkway, and then we put in something else and to show them that it's going to be happening. And once we got a couple of municipalities on board, the whole ball game changed. People started seeing that people were giving us donations and what they were getting in return, those beautiful black granite benches or the monuments. And they wanted to be involved. They wanted to honor their veterans at this memorial, and things started changing.
I'm proud of this and proud of the job that the committee's done putting this together for us.
Veterans like Luke Petrino were quick to see the project's value, and he wasn't alone.
The worst part about coming home from Vietnam, besides the 2.5-year wait I had to get both of my brothers home, was not being able to be proud that I served my country. And this here makes me proud.
I served 1st Marine Air Wing, flew as a courier, carried top secret classified documentation.
Is this long overdue for Ohio?
Oh, by all means. I'm glad this location was chosen. We're only 3 miles from here, but very long overdue. Mm-hmm. And other veterans as well, other wars. Time's gone by too quick.
I was in the Navy, spent 19 months off the coast in Tonkin Gulf mm-hmm. on a USS Berkeley DDG-15. This is great because this is just for Ohio, and Ohio has lost more men than any state in the Union. And we deserve this. They deserve this. Not us, but they do, mm-hmm. to have the recognition from their own state for this. And this is a great thing. I'm just tickled to death with it.
The Mekong Delta and the Gulf of Tonkin.
Does it feel like yesterday?
Sometimes we come out here at this wall, it does. It seems like it just was yesterday and brings back a lot of memories, but mm-hmm. we're glad we're back, and, you know, it's hard to really talk about a lot of it.
It's sad. You know, it brings back old memories, so.
Yeah. Is it easier or is it difficult to still?
It's difficult. Oh, yeah. Because, there's a lot of people, you know, at that time and back in the 60s and 70s, that when you were young, you didn't know any better. But now, it's hard to adjust even 30, 40 years later.
Name by name, panel by panel, the wall rose up. The mission to honor Ohio's fallen heroes taking shape. And it didn't take long for the imagery to touch the hearts of those who served.
Yeah, drift back a little bit. When I was at the Marine Barracks at 8th and I in Washington, D.C., we buried on the average of 9 Marines a day at Arlington. And from that, I came down here last night and sat at the wall in the dark with the lights on, and I gazed at the wall, and I just wondered how many names on that wall that I actually had buried at Arlington from Ohio. But it would be a bit of an undertaking to find that out, but bringing back some private moments.
I can tell you this much. In 41 years, I've never had a conversation about Vietnam with my older brother. He refuses to talk about it. He's never been to Washington, D.C. to see the wall there. He won't go, but we're going to get him here.
A lot of times, conflicts take the front page at the beginning, and then as it drags on, mm-hmm. People tend to forget about it. It gets put on the back page. It's not the top story anymore. And a lot of people don't even realize there's 2 conflicts going on now. And in Vietnam, people kind of forgot about it. They didn't agree with it. But you need to remember the soldiers were just there doing their job and their duty. They need to be remembered for that and honored.
So you're from Ohio. You served honorably in Vietnam.
Yes, I did.
It's been 30 plus years.
Oh, yeah.
What does this mean to you to see this?
It means a lot because, well, one guy down on the wall, he was one of the first ones. His name was Q. He was one of the first ones from our neighborhood in Akron to die in Vietnam. See his name. My wife's cousin, her brother got killed. He was one of the first ones killed in Vietnam. His name's on the wall, so there's quite a few.
I think the hope is that make people stop and think and remember those who have served their country. There's 4 generations of my family that have lived in the United States, and so far we've all served our country.
And my dad just passed away last year, and it really meant a lot to him to see that his sons, as he was the youngest, his son was on the wall and stuff. It's pretty emotional especially for the parent. You can imagine, I can't imagine, what it would be like to lose one of your children, especially something as horrific as war. So, but yes, it means a lot, both as a veteran and as a someone that has a family member on the wall.
This is the least I can do. Look what they've done for us. This is a little bit of payback. for the, especially now for the families. The veterans are not here, but their memories are here, but the families are still here. And they need to know how much we appreciate and honor these guys for what they did. They didn't find that out when they came home, and we're a little late in doing it, but we're doing it.
I belong to a group right now called Gathering of Eagles, and we have our mission is never again. What that means is never again will one generation of veterans turn their back on the next, like we felt happened to us when we came home from Vietnam. The World War II vets and the Korean War vets didn't back us up. And all the stuff that's happened to the Vietnam vets over the years is partly their fault. And that's why all these groups are organized and backing these kids that are doing our dirty work today. And we're going to make sure that that doesn't happen to them.
It means the country is not going to forget you for your service. It might be long overdue, which this is, but in the end, the people of the country will remember your sacrifices.
It's almost indescribable how a solid and unmoving object can bring so many to such strong emotions. But not every name etched here died in battle. Other spots bear the names of those who made it home, including the brick walkway, where Robin Probonik made the investment to honor her husband's service.
I bought a brick for my husband for our anniversary. I wanted it to be a surprise, but I couldn't because I didn't have all the information that needed to be on it. But I just wanted his name and the time that he spent in the service to, you know, to be there forever.
It's a private thing. I look at the wall, I look at those names, and I think of things that I did while I was over there. But these people, these grown adults, when you go to Vietnam as a kid, you come back as an adult. These guys never made it home. And we think we have life easy. Those people aren't with us to share all that now. It's a tribute.
We've been out here since the groundbreaking days, and we've followed it, been on poker runs to raise money for it, and we'll be here next weekend for the dedication.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Or am I all alone? If you return me to my home, boy, I will kiss you, Mother Earth. Take me back now. Take me back now. The poor.
Color guard, halt.
This is not a day of sadness, by no means. It's rather a time to rejoice as we bring together Vietnam veterans on this day. We welcome you home, a long overdue homecoming. This is the beginning of a memorial that every Ohio veteran who served with such honor and valor can now call their own.
I've spoken with other Gold Star mothers and family from different war periods. Many from the Vietnam War, What people shared and went through is unimaginable to me. One of the mothers I spoke with was from Cleveland, and she said that she had the knock-knock on her door, and by the time she got to her door, there was a postcard put in the door stating that she had lost a son in Vietnam. I can't fathom that. No explanation or anyone to speak with. Also, I spoke with other families that have lost a brother or sister in the Vietnam era, and they had unattended funerals or no support from family, community. When I look out now, I have learned that the American people have learned from the past mistakes and will not allow for the same thing to happen in the future.
We are privileged here today to have with us Patricia Powell from Canton. She is the president of the Sharon Lane Memorial Chapter number 199, the Vietnam Veterans of America. This is the only Ohio Vietnam Veterans of America chapter that is named after a woman.
Almost 40 years ago, Sharon was serving at the 312th Evac Hospital in Chulai, Vietnam. She was working the midnight shift, which she enjoyed because she wasn't an early riser. While she was finishing her paperwork, ending her shift, a 122-millimeter rocket was fired by the Viet Cong. Of all the wards it could hit, it hit the Vietnamese ward where Sharon was working, a ward that not many people wanted to work on, as you can well understand, taking care of the Vietnamese, POWs, and civilians. But she enjoyed her job. When that rocket hit, Sharon was immediately killed as a piece of shrapnel went across her carotid artery. It is a privilege to be the president of the chapter that bears Sharon Lane's name, an honor and a privilege. There's a statue at Altman Hospital, and on that statue are the 127 men at the base that were from Stark County that were killed during Vietnam. On top of that base is Sharon, a statue of Sharon and her utilities. And I think that this is appropriate. On that base, it says, born to honor, ever at peace.
Years from now, no one will remember who gave the shortest speech or even what was said, what the weather was like or how many people attended. What people will remember, and this is a testament to all of you and all the tireless, dedicated volunteers who made this Memorial Park happen, is that these men and women will never be forgotten. Their names will not fade from history. Here, family, friends, brothers in arms, and all those that love our great country have a place to reflect, to cry, to keep promises, to heal, and to remember. Lastly, we have all come here to celebrate. We celebrate life. We celebrate their short lives. Long after newspaper clippings turn yellow from age and old photos fade, long after death, this Memorial Park will still be here. The memories of these young men and women will remain.
Now, 5 years ago, a handful of people got together and decided to build the Ohio Vietnam Veterans Memorial Park. Now, somewhere down the line, they decided to change that and make this the All Ohio Veterans Memorial Park. And that's what we're standing in today. Now, they spent the last 5 years begging, borrowing, and stealing to build this memorial for us. They begged money from anybody that would listen. They borrowed just about anything they could, and most of it they kept. What they stole was every minute of spare time that they had from their families, and they deserve all the credit for what you see here today.
We've been fighting the global war on terror for 2 years and 10 months longer than World War II. From the day Desert Storm kicked off, January 17, 1991, every day the Air Force has been in continuous combat, along with its brothers and sisters in arms in the Army, Navy, Coast Guard, and the Merchant Marine. For 18 years, our enemies have shot at us, and for 18 years, America has answered the challenge. Unfortunately, as in all hostile situations, the risks are great. Lives are lost. Many more bear permanent scars, physical and mental, that will never be forgotten. Life is easy when your biggest worry is not having a ring around the collar, when you wear nothing except English leather. And I know I'm getting to some of you who are in your 50s and 60s who remember those commercial words. And you can take it all off with Noxzema. And you get coupons and discounts and rebates and money backs and guarantees for everything you buy. Yep, remember those commercial lines that said, in effect, life is fun and you can double your pleasure simply by chewing the right gum. You can get relief from backaches with a legal small white pill and feel wonderful because you are part of the Pepsi generation. And you got it all the old-fashioned way. You inherited it because you're lucky enough and blessed by God to have been born in the United States of America. So if you enjoy living in a nation, if you enjoy living in a nation representing 7% of the world's population with 50% of the world's so-called goodies, and you enjoy living a lifestyle involved and envied by all, look left, look right, thank a vet.
What does the wall mean to you?
Oh, geez. I can't really express it in words, really. It's emotional, really emotional, and glad to see it. You know, it's come about. It's been a long time coming. We've been working with it. Well, myself, I've been with it about 3 months, you know, as far as doing the work, getting physical with it. Mm-hmm. But before that, I talked to a lot of other people that try to get it in different areas of the state, but I'm glad it's done, and you know it's coming along real good.
I get choked up, just like everybody else. I mean, it's something in my past, and it's important to me and to my family. Like I said, both my brothers are Vietnam vets, and I just come here for a little solace and solitude.
History. I don't think they're teaching a lot in schools now about enough history, past history, even beyond Vietnam, all wars. It's inevitable that something's going to happen somewhere down the road, God forbid. We learn by mistakes.
I hope they see the camaraderie of the Vietnam veteran out here. The veterans that come out for this, they're going to see a lot of veterans out here hugging each other, shaking hands, talking to each other like we've known each other for years, and we met today. But that's a camaraderie that we have from being in a war. It's a brotherhood that, unless you're there, nobody can understand.
They paved the way for us And years from now, hopefully someone will do that for my generation of veterans.
More than three decades now since the last shot was fired in Vietnam, Ohio can finally have a single place to pay tribute to its Vietnam veterans. This park is now open, and they hope to draw thousands in the first year to a village that only has 1,300 people. And certainly every name on that wall has meaning and a family and a story worth remembering. And while the debate over Vietnam will probably linger forever, Ohio can now be united in saying thanks to its Vietnam veterans. I'm Eric Mansfield. Thanks for watching.
I got a friend named Whiskey Sam. He was my boony rat buddy for a year and now. He said, I think my country got a little off track. It took him 25 years to welcome me back. But it's better than not coming back at all. Many a good man I saw fall. And even now, every time I dream, I hear the men and the monkeys in the jungle scream. Drive on, it don't mean nothing. My children love me, but they don't understand. And I got a woman who knows a man. Drive on, it don't mean nothing, it don't mean nothing. Drive on.